It has everything.
Big Boy Neighborhood, boy. Ladies and gentlemen, DeRay Davis is in the neighborhood. Hey. DeRay, welcome to the neighborhood. This is our first time doing this.
This, yeah. Right here. Yeah, man. Keeping it up. I've seen you everywhere,
I know,
brother.
Man. I thought you were anti doing my show, to tell you the truth.
No, man. I wanted to come down. I didn't feel important enough. When I see the people you have.
You crazy as hell.
I'm not going to lie. When I see the people you have, I'm always like, man, I need to do more to make it to that show. When the first radio station I listened to, I'm about 17, 18 years in. First radio station, I was like, man, if I make it to Big Boy,
man,
I've done something with my life.
Go ahead now.
You know what I mean?
I'm going to take it as a compliment.
It is.
Well, I'm glad that you finally done something with your life.
Thank you, man.
But no,
I'm out them streets, man.
I'm a fan first, though, bro. Like, you always, and just sitting here talking with you off air, this has been like a process, bro. You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
You know how when you see somebody like, oh, he's funny. You're like, no, man, I've been doing this.
I'm in it, man. Like, I'm not missing no free throws when I get to the league.
I heard exactly.
I get to the league, I'm not missing their free throws. Ass closed, letting it ride. I always tell people, DeRay Davis is, I've had so many pop-up shops. Now I got the stove. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly, brother.
Keep a pop-up shop.
Hey, man, when did you figure out that comedy was you? You know what I'm saying? Like, were there any jobs before comedy started paying you, DeRay?
Yeah, it was always, I mean, the street job was always there. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. And as a matter of fact, that's what kind of led me to comedy. My uncle was a bartender at a comedy club,
mm-hmm.
and I would make runs for him. So I went to the comedy club and I saw comedy live first. I had never seen it on TV. I ain't had no cable,
right?
No Def Comedy Jam, wasn't no Comedy View. I just saw it live. I was like, what is dude up there doing? It's like, tell jokes on the mic. I'm like, oh, that looked fun.
Were you always the homie that was kind of on the block and people always say, man, he's funny?
No, because everybody was funny on the block. Everybody could roast. My mom was funny.
Yeah.
My mama would roast you about stuff she did for you. Like, my mom be like, look at your jeans. I'm like, you bought these jeans. What are you talking about?
Oh,
be rude.
Tiny ass shirt.
Where your daddy at? You should tell me where my daddy at.
That's why you don't know your father.
Right.
Boom.
Wait, this is all what, man, you say?
Like,
but yeah, my whole family, though, was good at roasting. So I always took that as, like, I guess my first time going on, Corey Holcomb was in the audience.
Now, Corey, if y'all don't know him, that's a bad boy right
Doug,
there.
What's up, Doug? Corey Holcomb in the building.
That dude.
So Corey was there, and I was supposed to do 5 minutes, and I did 18 minutes.
Your first time up or early
on? Stage.
Wow.
I was on stage. I did 18 minutes, and I was just wrote. I had a book of notes I wanted to tell jokes from, but I was getting heckled. And that's when I was like, oh, this is my thing. This is my niche.
Yeah, this is what I do.
And I got heckled by a guy named Gemini, who was in a group called Men at Large.
Oh, man.
I'm so alone.
You never miss a good thing.
Yeah. So they was in the audience.
And for those who don't know Men at Large, he's a large man.
Won Apollo about four times, but he was in the audience. And I started roasting him. I mean, I went in. I'm so much more merciful now.
Right.
You know.
Yeah, see,
like, if I'm on the block, I'm roasting people. Like, I've had people stop me. I'm the kind of guy that, I'm still a street fighter. Like,
right. Yeah. Hell
you
yeah.
You want to roast with me at Dunkin' Donuts? We just get it in. Middle of Miami, middle of the block. I
yes,
stop.
Sir.
I could be with the most nicely situated situations around me. I'll be like, y'all get in the car. I got this dude trying me. Let me get to it. Keep my gloves heavy.
Hi, Yugen.
Yeah, like, so I went in on them. And then Damon Williams, who put me up first, Chicago, he put me on stage first. He was like, yo, you got this. This is you're a natural. He said, I've met a few naturals, but you got this. And then 5 months later, I won the Miller Comedy Search. Well, I took second, and then Marcus Combs went first. And this is a competition that Bernie had won, Saturday Entertainment had won after years of comedy. They had won it, but a couple months I won it. Year after that, I'm learning the game as I stood by the door and watched a guy who was taking the money at the door. His name was Tossie. He was taking the money and he was paying people the night. It was like $15. And I was like, I want to be him.
Yeah. I want to be the right hand.
I want to be that dude.
Not like, the left hand.
This is cool, but I want to be him. So I'll say within maybe 2 years, I was already producing shows and booking shows. Then I owned a comedy club.
Damn. With, wow.
Yeah.
That's dope.
Did you and your first time out, 18 minutes, and you do well. But when every comedian bombs, and sometimes they say your first time and even your bomb, but what did that feel
my
like?
My first time ever bombing was my first time ever performing in L.A. at the place I host on Mondays when I'm there. the LA Improv.
Really?
I went up to do a showcase, and people kept saying showcase, showcase. I was like, what the hell is a showcase? They're like, we're going to showcase, see if we want to give you TV. I'm like, I don't know what this is. So I go on stage, and they're like, and I'm doing this. I'm trying not to curse. I'm trying not to do
stuff. Out of the element kind of. Yeah.
And out of the 30 people in there, it was my worst show ever. But other than that, I've had bad shows, but not because of me.
Right.
Because I put myself in situations where I'm like, I shouldn't be opening up for Red Man and Method Man.
Right. Yeah. Right.
With 20 minutes of comedy.
Yeah.
And they an hour late.
Yeah. Man, so the 30 that you did bomb in front of, that was just like.
It felt industry. Like, but then after that, next day I'm getting phone calls, and before you know it, I'm in the laugh
riots. Did you bomb by their standards or your standards?
Mine. After I leave there, I'm in the laugh riots after that, Comedy Central. This is all within like 2 years of comedy. Mm. Won the laugh riots. On the same day I won the laugh riots, exact same. I went and pitched a TV show to ABC, and that night I walked out with my manager. I said, wouldn't it be funny if I won a contest tonight too? And I won a contest that same night. Whatever day that was.
This is some like destiny kind of stuff. Either that was on Friday.
That was on. But
either that or you're lying to us.
He's a liar, man.
Google all that.
He's a liar.
Well, you can't really lie about it because it's Googleable.
It's so many slashes when we come to. We can say movie star.
Star with rapper. I like rapper.
Rapper extraordinaire. Did you ever try rapping though, D-Ray?
I'm actually really, really good at rapping.
Give us some bars.
I'm really good.
Man, I'm probably going to have to put on the
Instagram. Everybody know I'm nice. You know, on my Instagram lately, because I've been hearing all the bumness out. I've been spitting
go
on
get DJ head,
I've been
man.
Spitting
I get a
on my Instagram lately, man. Just going in, just because I want to show what nice is. You know
were you
saying?
Ever part of a group though? You know, I was. How you know, when you I throw said things when I, up against the wall and whatever stick, you're like, okay, the comedy stuck. So
no. I was always for me, but I worked with Eric Sermon for a long time.
Yeah, that's my guy.
I was signed to Bernard.
Go ahead now.
Bernard was my manager.
Did you think like, man, this is about to happen?
Oh yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
When I first was freestyling with them and kicking it, and then I remember when I had my deal first and Kanye's deal was coming, Kanye was doing music. I remember being in Miami and down there working, and I got a call, and Kanye was on the phone. He's like, yo, what's up? And it's John Monopoly in Chicago connected me and Kanye on the phone that day. This is before, you know, we were just talking on the phone. And I remember Kanye rapped for about 8 minutes, nonstop.
Hey, dude, Kanye was Kanye back then, huh?
Nonstop. He rapped. I mean, there was no interrupting, there was no interlude.
How did you, is that the way you and Kanye met? Because I know after that it was through the wire. We met
because I was doing the comedy clubs out there, and he had the World Record Holders was a group in Chicago. And I would have their mixed CDs at my shows, and I would play them and stuff. So
damn.
And so you knew Kanye before.
Yeah. So when I got here, I was sitting in the hotel room. He was playing through the wires. You see in the video.
Yeah.
We're driving to the. I was driving them to the studio, to drive to listening to through the wire, and I was just talking. And when I got down there, they trying to get in touch with Bernie, trying to get in touch with people to do the skits. Mm-hmm. And I had never done an impression or nothing, but I was just playing around doing the brand. I was like, Kanye, Gaze, I'll do it for a minute. I didn't even know I could do it.
Hey,
I
man, what's your relationship with Kanye now?
I haven't talked to Kanye. Oh, I seen him in the club like you did.
Right here. Yeah.
But I think, this is how people always say that, but I think if I had grew up with Kanye, it'd be way different.
Right, you know,
We grew up in the industry together, so I think that's a different, I can't expect Kanye as a father, as an artist, as a what all he going through. You know what I mean?
Be, hey, what up?
Whether it be good or bad. Yeah, to be like, what? Text me. But if he has some artistry coming up, but I always see his people out. Like, obviously, Don, or whatever. Yeah. Now I run to Don, those people. But when I think if it comes up to being creative in something, he know who to call for what this situation is. Like for the other skits, he knew who to call. He knew when I did the Broke Five Broke, you know, what I was going to bring to it. And he knew after that, when we was going to do the other skits, when we weren't clicking, it wasn't making sense. Hence,
you know
Chris
what I get
Rock,
from a lot of cats, and I knew Kanye early on as well, but you've known him longer, where people say, oh, well, he's arrogant or he's confident, he's this, he's that. Kanye was like that from my first meeting with him.
Excited about him.
It just, and how big he was going to be or how.
I would still say there's a shyness that people miss. Like, if you look at the videos, rarely looking at the camera. Mm-hmm.
Right.
Always the even the dances, he's turned away. Performances within himself, the confidence is when you ask somebody about his painting and he's describing his painting.
Right.
And this is why I use this paint.
Yes.
And this is the reason I did this, because you're passionate about that. But I'll say, like, as far as being cocky, like, I remember being outside the club and through the wire was playing. We were standing outside waiting to get in. Like, hey, this is a song.
And he didn't even do that. That's my song.
And I'm like, yo, what the hell? That was me. Like, the hell going on? But I've always been a a PR person for things I'm
no, not passionate. You. No. Yeah, you know, I don't see that.
Yeah, anymore. Man, I gotta. Hey, I gotta let it be known.
DeRay, you saying on your social profiles now, mm-hmm. you freestyling more.
Just, yeah, man, just rapping to be rapping. But I don't, you know what I'm saying? I want to curse somebody out right now.
Oh man, no, we
gotta go.
We gonna
mean?
Go ahead and hold on. Let me make sure that we all plugged in over here.
Let me get
here
it.
We go, man. Is this written?
Yeah, go yeah. Ahead, I guess it's written when I'm spitting until I'm quitting. Why you making me freestyle like I want to? Cause I'm cutting like scissors and I could get on the phone, I could probably call RZA and he'll tell you how nice I am. On step, push record, cause you can't really do it. Don't step on my cord. Back in the day, good grades in my report. Not card, nigga, but still a hard nigga. Stay in charge, nigga, like credit card niggas. I'm sitting here just hoping for six more figures. Don't need the seven, cause Chi-Town to rob me if they knew what I had, but I'll give it out gladly. Man. My freestyle so cold that it sound written down. I'm a comedian, not a clown. And now you ask me, was it written? So fuck the bullshit. Let me give them something that they know ain't bitten. Here we go. Considering Oscars when I step on the stage, I never been afraid. I'm like a in the cage and still freestyling while I go back to there. This ain't wild style, no Nick Cannons, but I got them. Don't bring that up because in Vegas when they shot him, we was hurt by that. Matter of fact, they need less gas and more conversations about that. What happened to slap boxing and rap? Man, come on. So slick when I spit it. I don't give a fuck about the critics. Man, I will admit it. Been to jail a couple times, always gotta quit it. Always.
Hey, man.
If you don't give a fuck, I don't give a fuck either. Take it outside, I'll make them duck from the heater. Say, we the kings of this pimping procedure. Leader of a life that's prestigious. You need us to rock like Shell Toe with Jesus. The deed is Jesus, don't leave us, but lead us. In a world full of dangerous demons and non-believers, sprouting out scandalous semen into the fetus, to grow into a soul so cold to mistreat us. Hate us like Al-Qaeda, but knowing they can't beat us. Who the fuck want what? From the street to the speaker, treat you like a clump, it's our short walk cleaters. Chi-Town monsters are true go-getters. Nothing can defeat us if we, man.
DeRay, you nice, boy.
I'm just having fun, man.
DeRay, you
fun,
nice,
man.
Boy.
Just having
you
fun with it.
Man? You nice, boy. Saturday night, man. Big Boys Comedy Night at Morongo Casino Resort and Spa. This is our first time working like this together,
finally,
bro.
Finally, man.
Yeah,
necessary,
man.
Too.
Very necessary.
Appreciate the alley-oop, man. It's gonna be a good time down there. Yo, I'm showing up. When I get there, from the moment I get there, I'm single till I leave, ladies.
There it is. So you are single. Enter and exit.
Enter, yeah.
And exit. Yeah. But enter then once
exit.
You get out.
Out of there. Back to the situation.
There it is. You know what is saying? The situation, yeah. Man? Are you married?
I have a very comfortable situation.
I heard
brother.
That, brother. It seems like you don't want to talk about it.
No, I don't matter. It's just, I've been this last year. I've been feeling like I'm going backwards and trying to explain because people keep saying I have two girlfriends.
Okay, you wait. Do you have two girlfriends?
I do have two girlfriends.
Okay.
Wait,
wow. I have two girlfriends.
Okay,
and
how
I'm
does
very
this happen? Is it too late for me? I'm married.
No, it's not, brother.
Okay,
just
all
a
right.
Conversation.
Not that I want to.
Now, it might end in death for you.
It
but
could.
Other
you know what I'm saying?
But at least you say you had two girlfriends on the way out. You
so
know
you
what
have
saying?
Two girlfriends for real?
I do, man, and they're very comfortable. So everybody's question. Good in their situation, and I'm not a player.
DeRay, look me in the eyes, man. You really have two girlfriends.
I have two,
and they know about each other.
They live together.
They live together.
What? You live with two girls?
You writing a book?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah,
how did you manage to do
situation.
That?
Do they have each have a relationship with you, and then they have a relationship?
Yes.
Okay.
Well, they have their own relationship, which is really strong. I'm really I've how can I say this? I'll say I've achieved greatness in this with the help of them because I've always done it. Like I've always like been honest. Like I'm gonna have two girls. I always said I'm gonna have two girls. Like because when you're dating, you're looking for somebody. This is the excuse I give women all the time who. They say I'm promiscuous or make mistakes. Mm-hmm. I say, dudes have lied to women for so long. So right. Why would she come out giving you all of her truth, all of who she is? Yeah, she's dating one guy. So one guy might be a ball player. One guy might be a garbage man. Mm-hmm. End of the day, though, somebody she doesn't know who she wants to be with because she's decided she wants to be with somebody before.
Mm.
And of all them times, it's been terrible.
So with
so my explanation is this: if you've done it your way a long time. I ask the women, how many? If you want 10 people you've been with, you ain't got to. How many relationships you think you've been in, and why were they not successful?
Right.
What happened? He did this. He lied about that. Well, we're not gonna do that.
Yeah, we're gonna
let's
start
eliminate
with the beginning.
That first.
Yeah, okay.
And this is what it is. Now I want you to.
Did you have
introduce
a relationship? Oh, you okay? That's what I was gonna say. Like I didn't
know. I'm already ahead of these questions.
I know.
and that helps too.
What's your favorite cereal?
No, I'm just kidding. That helps too.
So what was the question that was about to be asked?
How it all like started? Was it that he had a relationship with one first and then introduced?
Or is that the way it was?
Both at the same time?
Well, that was another young lady whom when we was on TV. That was another young lady I've known for many years who we were friends. And then I introduced her to the situation.
Are these famous women?
No.
Okay, go ahead.
No, we filmed this. It was on Oxygen. And I had a TV reality show. I had the two girls.
How the hell did
the
I miss that?
Yeah, Michael Black. We had this Living with Funny. Michael Black was on the show. Brandon T. Jackson was on the show.
How many years have you guys been together?
Well, I was with
the first one
for now. We're going on 5 years, and now the other one is 2 years in. So
damn.
And they never like fight, or there's never like jealousy.
Oh, no.
You know, can you shake his hand for me too?
I'll say what they fight about is stuff that. In a regular like it's like who like they might fight over who ate my chips
right,
type
right.
thing, but really? Never about who we are.
Do y'all all sleep in the same bed, or is it like you can sleep with me tonight?
No,
you
know, yeah. I mean, of course, but we have multiple beds, so
right.
People want to For the most part, though, just for the super comfort of it, which I learned by listening to Dennis Rodman, by the way, who said my wife will always live next door.
Right.
Because we got comfort.
I hear you.
You got your space, I got mine. You can, like, I don't mind them having a key to my place, but I don't want a key to y'all place. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's y'all comfort zone. I don't need to walk in and
so
see.
So y'all don't live together?
You don't live
together. Oh, y'all live together. Okay.
I'm saying, for the rest of my life, this is what it's going to be. Like, we're all leaving. We're going to vacay. We're going to Chicago for my show. We'll be there in my house there for 4 weeks at a time. But for the most part, everybody got their own space.
Right.
So, like, if you are at home with one of them and you want to smash and you guys are smashing and the other girl comes in, she's not mad that you guys are smashing without her, or?
I've always lived in a very comfortable situation. I want to say it, but without science. But you know what? Who I want to thank for this? I want to thank Amber Rose.
Really?
I do right now. Not for the relationship, for me being a voice how I feel as a man.
Right,
not
right, right.
I'm not a slut.
Yeah, no. Exactly.
Okay, I'm not a pimp. I ain't a Mac. I ain't nothing like that. I've laid out my situation where I want it. Why?
And plus, you're not lying.
You're not.
Everything else we do in life, I know what I want exactly. It's never a problem. It's like, oh, I want 6 phones around me.
Right.
Like, oh, you a phone.
Yeah, you got all the phones.
But if it comes to relationships, as much as relationships are so tainted now and so messed up, you telling me that you can, and beautiful at the same time, gay people can get married. Congratulations to all that they do. You know what I'm saying? I live in a situation now where if them two want to get married, I'll be, you know, I'm the side chick. You know what I'm saying? I'm the situation. You know what I'm saying?
Did you lay down with last night? And I'm not saying smash it, but.
Well, both of them were doing, they're both, I want to say this too. There's no where they daddy's at.
Right.
Where their mama's at. Where they must come from broken homes. Nope. Nobody was no stripper at first. Nobody was touched when they were little, and now they're thinking different about stuff. Everybody had to be. I mean, Pete, it was these kind of conversations. I ain't doing that. What you think I am? I don't know what you used to, but my man, my last man, I don't care about all that. Can you just listen to me and try? And if it makes sense,
I'm surprised
afterwards.
You stood up and or you walked in here with you because your legs are good and everything.
Yeah, my legs. And if you notice,
it's hard for me to satisfy my woman.
And if you notice, brother,
you're happy.
And nothing's.
You're happier than anyone in this room.
Yes. Brothers, nothing's died. There's no Beijing.
Right.
And you see the guys a little younger than me.
Yeah.
How many grades can you count? Probably can count about 3 grades realistically. But that's real. That's natural. Comfortable, dog. Right,
so, okay. Call my wife.
And you know, every time people say that, I get cursed out.
I will not call.
I'll just say that it's very comfortable and everybody's encouraging everybody to be good in life. Like, be the best you can be. And if you're ever uncomfortable, you can always be like, you gotta tell me why you're going. Or you can't just be like, I'm slamming the door. I'm out of here with you.
Do you put that in your jokes?
I do not.
No,
because it's not a joke.
It's not a joke, and it's not just a joke. It's just not knowing. And I'm so good with the other stuff. Like, you know what I mean? This strays from it. Like last year, kind of took away from it. It's like on the red carpet. Like, we went to the BT Awards. You'll see the pictures. They look beautiful. Next, to, like we went to the Def Jam Awards.
See, I thought that was your publicist.
I need to look.
Publicist and manager.
That's awesome, bro.
They're gorgeous.
Yeah, they're pretty girls.
Man, I heard.
Some guys have a hard time pulling one good looking
girl. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? You done got back in line. Like, what are you doing?
Hey, man. I'm not, like I said, it's not a bragging thing. I just think that honesty is important. I think a lot of people live that life, but they're so secretive about it. And then out of nowhere, your car gets keyed, your windows get busted.
Damn.
You get things cut off.
Yep. Yeah.
I don't want to be stabbed. I want to be just walking around.
And then you know what? A lot of people just say they want the truth. Mm-hmm. And you know, and then early on, if they want the truth, and sometimes people can't handle the truth. That's a, you looking at some right now, Ide? That's an old one.
I'm looking at them.
She's gone, but this one's gone, and we don't. I don't. She was such a good friend of mine for so long. I try not to discuss it. The problem.
Nah,
was,
I got you.
The problem was I was in expanding. There was a discomfort in, hey, it won't be no damn three of us.
Right, I hear you.
So that was the conversation.
Like three ladies.
Yeah. She was like, that won't. And I agreed. I said, I understand. So
you try to play your hand, though. You did try.
I meant. I'm one of the, I was on the D's with
you. Just one more.
All this,
did you, did all you all read your
saying,
resume?
Everything I'm saying right now sounded the same words but sounded different. But at least I'm being honest.
Yeah, but I'm being honest.
And like, what other man do like, this? Man. Higher voice. Oh,
yeah.
Really
yeah, when you go up an octave, that's when you know. Like, baby, what? You know, come on now. When you go up an octave, that's when you know, like, yeah, I'm begging. Yeah.
But I knew it was a comfort zone. I knew I had a different lifestyle when there would be times where I'd be, like, let's say I'm in the living room and something's happening for me. And somebody would say, hey, let me get her a hair tie.
Let her what?
Get her a hair tie.
Oh, like my God.
Another girl?
Yeah.
Oh, I love. Oh, that's.
My God.
I'll be right back.
I got it right.
Her hair's
I got
all over
instantly.
Yeah, yeah. All right.
I got it instantly.
Yeah, I'm done with you. You know what I'm saying? I'm done with you.
He's an honest
matter
freak.
Of fact, we're going to cancel
say.
The show.
But, but let's not forget DeRay, the actor.
Yes.
The comedian.
Exactly.
Who gives back to the hood.
You know what I love about you, too, though, DeRay?
I also have two aunties. We mention them. I pay, take care of their bills. Two uncles.
But
two daughters. I take care of them.
What I love about you, too, though, man, is that this don't supersize your talent. Like, that isn't the first thing that people ask you. That isn't the first thing
but
that
lately,
I ask you.
That's why I'm saying lately. No, not so, you, because you've known me for so long. But I've been in interviews. I'm like, so you have. I'm like,
I didn't even know until right now.
I'm like, so I'll take the.
Well, you know what? Let's take that, put that back in the compartment.
Yeah.
Know, little bitty box. And y'all stick around. You got
just
you locked
more.
And loaded with
one. Just oh one more.
Right,
I'm just fascinated by it. So are you in love with both of them?
I am.
Wow, because I just never knew. I've never believed
to get
that you could love.
I'm in love with both my
with
kids.
With two people,
you can.
But women,
it's so like
in
I
love.
It feels
I
so natural to me, like
people.
Walking through the grove with them holding hands and me just watching. Like it's just a natural.
Do y'all
it's not
ever
even,
hold hands together, yeah. All three, and tiptoe through the tulips?
Ain't no tulips.
Yeah, you know,
we hold hands. Watching this horror movie, we all gripped,
right,
holding each other, looking at.
So
the
when you leave here at some point today, you going home, and that's the living situation for real.
That is. And hopefully, wow. I don't know, and I feel kind of bad because I don't know everybody's school schedule at the moment. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like, because they're both in college, so
go
I'm like trying
now.
To figure they're both. I'm trying to figure. I did not ask that, and I usually ask, and I feel because I'm home for 2 weeks. I'm normally not home this long,
mm-hmm.
So now I got to say like who's around, like what y'all want to do before I plan, like because me I'll be like, yo, we all going to lunch. They like, and it's the regular conversation. Like, no, I can't go to lunch. I have to study. Like, it's like, all right.
Man, wow.
You're choosing to go to school.
Right? Yeah. Well,
sorry.
D-Ray, yeah. Hip-Hop Squares.
Hip-Hop Squares,
is the second
man.
Season going on right now?
Second season. We shot 20 episodes already.
Oh. And what was the first season? 20 episodes as
20
well?
Episodes, yeah.
So that's
Ice
40
Cube
episodes.
Be like, Ice Cube be like, go to work.
Let me tell you, man. I am deeply offended by Ice Cube, Brother Ron, Cube Vision, everybody. They shot
big.
40 hip-hop squares, mm-mm. And they still ain't put me in one.
That's crazy,
right.
Man. And I look at some of the people, I'm like, man, I could probably be right there. You know what I'm saying? Like,
there. I love how we do that as people be like, I'm better than that. You know,
you know, that's some black stuff though, man.
Yeah,
that's got, black and brown. Like, man, he on there?
Yeah, he on. What
oh,
am I gonna call?
Oh man,
I think it's. I don't. I have
it's
no
a good
idea.
Show, though.
What's
I ain't lying to you. You look fun.
I know that I had to fight to get somebody on. I mean, one person, and I'm hosting it. I had to. 15 texts in, and this person probably would have fought for me 30% of what I did.
Wow.
And still, not saying they just they're not as aggressive. In nature as I am,
mm-hmm.
So that in that
it?
Light, it's Gary Owen.
Oh, really though? Damn.
And it was Gary, and I said,
I like
Gary.
Gary.
I said Gary.
You say Gary in the neighborhood.
I said
as well.
Gary's funny, and he's my brother, and I don't got nobody on because I had a list of people
mm-hmm.
that my friends. I think no, I ran into the
that would be good on them squares,
dude. I had dreams of like the Wu-Tang being in every square. I was like,
imagine
but
dope.
I'm also not the producer, and I'm not Ice Cube, and I'm not cutting the checks. So it's like,
yeah.
You know, I had to work on, you know, doing, make sure I'm there as a proper host, but I needed Gary because I know comedically, you know, right now his show's not on and I know he's going to get back busy with mm-hmm. another show. But I also wanted to put people in position that I know going
to
pop.
But you seem
I mean?
Like a give and do when it comes to your peers as well, though, man. You
all
know
that.
What I'm saying?
All like, that. And you say, no matter what they say about me, no matter what's messed up, I've always put money in people's pocket. I've paid everybody.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? There's nobody that's going to say I did not pay.
Are there comedic beefs that go on? And have you ever been caught up in one?
Not really myself, because I'm in a position where I pay people.
Right.
But there, we argue all the time. There's people that's like brothers who argue, you know, in it. I feel like there's been some fights. There's been a couple.
Has there been any fist fights of anyone that we know?
Yeah, I'm sure. Wow. But I don't know if they went. Yeah, I'm sure. People fist fight.
Damn. What about stolen material?
Mm. All the time.
Have you been
stolen personalities?
Oh, wow. Have you been a victim of that?
I stay consistently a victim of it because I freestyle a lot. I'm on stage freestyle. So, but what I say now, I'm like, freestyle, I said, to the comedians in here who still, I'm probably going to use that. So please don't.
Wow, you got to put it out in the atmosphere. Yeah. Like, I know you're here.
I know you're recording. I'm going to find you. But you know, regardless of what you do, you steal, or however you think you're going to get to the point, man, talent, true talent and true perseverance and true, that's the only thing that you're going to get there. When you have that, regardless of the fact. You know what I mean? So all the people stealing, you just digging yourself a deeper hole.
Right.
Because you're not becoming yourself. So whoever hires somebody is not hiring you. They're hiring what somebody think else. You are. So that person who you stole it from is going to show up and be him, be himself. And they're going to be like, oh, our fault. You're not the guy we're looking for.
Yeah. There he is right there. DeRay Davis is in the neighborhood. And we were just talking off air. Just
now I had to call
Netflix.
Security. You know? Now it's more comedic beef. No, I'm kidding.
Now, you did a Netflix as well.
Yeah, I did.
All right. Congratulations
DeRay
to you
Davis, on that. My special comes out this year. DeRay Davis, How to Act Black.
How to Act Black. What is it like when you... Because Netflix, man... It's like a club now, bro. Like, you know,
I like that it was a one phone call. Like, I've been touring forever. I love just making up fresh material all the time and having fun and selling out my shows. And I saw Dave Chappelle and them deal, and I called my manager. Yeah. I said, hey, man, what's up with Netflix? He said, you want to do one?
You're like, hell yeah.
So, and he just made one phone call, and they came, they saw me one time. They was like, yeah, let's do a deal.
That's dope.
So it's DeRay. I was deciding what to call it. DeRay, I thought all these names, the hood hero, all my normal names, the street stars back. And they were like, man, you know what? White people ain't about to click on that.
Right.
So I was like, so I said, it's DeRay Davis, How to Act Black. And I basically, it's real cool. Tyrese showed up, shot in Atlanta. Tyrese was there. John Singleton was there. And not saying the names, I say because. I'm saying it because it felt like a real, like, it's necessary. Because John was an important part of me naming it that. Because I did Snowfall.
Mm-hmm.
And then I did Snowfall. I played the uncle. And then they recast everybody. And I guess me and Lauren London went, I guess we went dark enough. What I don't know what the hell we didn't get.
Oh, so they didn't use you for that?
Didn't use me.
Wow.
But I'm like, yeah, I did Snowfall on FX. But they, you know, John's just John's show. And John wrote the part for me. Like, I was cast before the lead was cast. John called me like, man, you about to kill us. And when I did the pilot, I said lines in the pilot. So when they recast, they wanted me to come reread to get back chemistry-wise. My lines that I freestyled in the pilot
are
in the script that I'm reading.
Oh,
so I sat
man.
There and said... They said, first of all, I want to let you know you did a good job in the pilot. I said, I know. My lines are right here. Yes. This is stuff my uncle said to me that y'all wrote down here. And I'm in the guild. But I left that audition feeling so good. It's one of my strangest auditions, but I left that feeling good because I know I made my statement clear.
Mm-hmm.
Very clear.
Damn.
That day.
And John, we're looking for a DeRay Davis type.
I made
we got DeRay, no, not him.
I made it so clear that when John called me 15 minutes after that, he was like, what did you do in there? I said, everybody.
Like I kept it real.
Because it was necessary.
Like they know me when I walked out.
So I felt How to Act Black is people telling you how to act like yourself. Like you acting black. And I know nobody knows how to act black like black people.
Mm-hmm.
Like real black people. Like real. We act black. Like it's a different thing. Acting black like on TV. Like, hey, man, type. That ain't acting black. Acting
See,
black.
Jive turkey, brother.
Yeah, that ain't acting black. Acting black is getting on the phone and somebody calling the house and you answer the phone and ask the person is they there when they next to you.
Right.
That's
you here. Yeah.
That's acting black.
We understand, brother.
Acting black is having your mother having two boyfriends and both of them really think they're your daddy.
Yes. Hello. Hey, man. And I don't even want to go
Christmas
toe for toe with you. Yeah.
from both of them.
And you got to just put daddy on there. Like, oh, man.
And you look like both of them. You start getting older. And then one dude start being like, hey, man.
And you have kids.
I ain't got good hair.
But you have kids, right?
Yeah.
I heard that, bro. What do you do for the holidays?
I cook.
You cook?
Very well, man.
What's your best dish?
Yeah, what's that?
I make everything, though, but I don't make, like, I'm not a bougie. Would you have, you do food? I could cook. Like, I'm a greens and cabbage and dressing and macaroni.
Oh,
and,
man.
And turkey, and I make everything.
And nice. So on Thanksgiving, you're going to be in Chicago, though, huh?
I'll probably be here cooking, then Christmas, we head out right, probably few weeks after.
Oh, good. Bring us some food.
Or we just all go over here.
She'll make a decision because I'm in Miami that weekend, so that's a hard thing to say. I'm going to cook on Thanksgiving, but make it to Miami on Friday.
You got shows
out
there?
I got a show on that Saturday.
Jesus Christ, boy. How many shows do you think you do a year?
I don't even try to think about it, man. Yeah, I know I've done 12 in a weekend before, though.
What?
Broken records. Yeah.
You've done 12 damn. Shows in a weekend?
In Houston, only guy to ever do it. 12 in a weekend.
He's tapping and looking around like, yeah. Ever. You know what I do?
Do the numbers on that.
Definitely want to thank you for coming into the neighborhood, man. Any more movies coming up for you before the
year's
up?
No. Actually, just about to go back to robbing people. You know what I'm saying?
You should.
No, you know what
I'm saying?
I'm telling you how I feel, man. I feel like the Netflix special is really good, and I honestly think everything I'm in, I always think I look ugly. Like, I'm always the, you know, there's the Mike Ealy, and then there's the DeRay. I'm like the what is it called? Superman? He got the
right, like the alter ego.
No, the ego. I feel like I'm that guy.
He's a Clark Kent.
I always feel like I'm an ugly brother in my family. Aww. Type shit. I always feel like that. So I feel like on this.
You know what? That's kind of disrespectful to us ugly people, though. You know what I'm saying? Like, people wouldn't walk up and be like,
I've been called green ass fish. I got called everything when I was little. Little ass teeth. But I feel like. I feel like when I was when I shot this, though, and just everything coming together, and I look a little rough on it, but I feel like it's the best I've ever looked on TV, man. I got a suit jacket and I felt comfortable because I've tried to perform a suit jacket and never felt comfortable, but this one was stretchy and I got into it. I feel like after this come out, we're gonna be talking about a lot more movies.
As we should, because
people have called. I just got a call for a movie for Monday, but I'm waiting. I just want to see what this.
So
does.
It's 2017 when this. How to Act Black?
How to Act Black.
And that's 2017, though.
2017.
Man, you got to come back and let's hang out, bro.
Yeah, man. Believe that. But get at me on Twitter and everything, at DeRay Davis or whatever. Ladies, if you're sending news, please don't have a man. Don't have a child that could be affected by it later in life.
Right.
I don't know who might get my phone, steal my phone. There's a lot going on, man.
Hey, man, do you get a lot of that in your DM?
Yeah, I do. Have some thought process going into your news. That's all I'm saying.
I heard that. But they really send them to you?
Yeah, I get news. I get a lot worse.
Like real ones?
Worse than news. It's a lot going on sometimes.
Do you get them, Louis?
Nah.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Do you know what I get?
I get, can you check out my music?
Oh. I get, can you check out my music?
My fire music.
But it be with a nude.
Nah, man. I don't think I've ever, but you know what?
It'd
I don't go through my DMs
tape
either, though.
To her ass.
I don't really go through the DMs either. Maybe I've missed something. You know what I'm saying?
I'm pretty sure you get some nudes are disgusting.
Really? Sending news is the new Playboy magazine.
Damn. Do you get them, Natalia?
I don't look in them.
Have you ever got surprised or don't lie? You better
go. I don't go in there.
Disgusting. I don't like it. It's gross. This dude sent me one. He's just like laying there on the couch.
That was me.
Show Chrissy underwear.
Hey, they're comfortable. Yeah. Don't call me this dude. Call me Big Boy. Well, DeRay Davis, thank you for coming into the neighborhood. I appreciate you. No, we're going to see you again.
Yeah.
DeRay Davis in the neighborhood. Big Boy.
Big Boy.